2020 has been a challenging year, globally and locally. But thanks to the unsung heroes of small communities like Sidney by the Sea, there has been so much hope and so much inspiration, and we wanted to spotlight some of these champions and share their stories with you.
We decided to start a meal program. So through a grant from the United Way of Greater Victoria, we started a meal program in May. We had about 17 people we were delivering meals to, and now our list is 230.
That's not really us. We don't just quit. And we put together 3 raffle baskets, purchased everything locally, and then we did an online form or an online shop and sold raffle tickets, and we actually doubled what we made from previous years.
I rolled out a digital map where we would have a link to all the businesses, and we'd be in touch with all the businesses. Are you open for business? What are your hours? How can people find you?
Pacifica Real Estate also created a shop local campaign with their Pacifica Ripples video series.
The idea is to really, again, stay off the mouse a little bit, you know, from Amazon and shop local.
It's always been important to me to try to give back as much as we can to Sydney. We definitely had a lot of waste when we closed our doors, so making donations to the food bank was one of the ways that we really tried to avoid a catastrophe as far as waste was concerned. It was important to us to really try to support each other during that really difficult, scary time.
We came up with this support Pay It Forward program, and the whole idea behind that was each of the staff would buy a gift certificate and then CFirst Insurance matched that. So we raised $16,200 doing that, which was fantastic. And then also we support the Think Local First initiative, and through that we've raised almost $500,000 for small business.
We just knew early on that the truckers had nowhere. They were not being welcome at restaurants. There was no washroom facilities for them, and so they were kind of left to their own devices. And yet, when you think about it, probably 99% of the things we use here on the island come by truck. So the town responded really quickly and set up an emergency truck stop here in the Mary Winspear parking lot. And care facilities were the first ones to be shut down. And some of the staff from one of them here in Sydney actually reached out and said, "We're really concerned about connecting our clients that are living in residence with their families."
The Chamber also took the lead in an innovative idea to help seniors in care stay connected to their loved ones.
And so I reached out to one of my contacts at TELUS, and they responded with a whole, it was just almost an embarrassment of riches of the tablets that they provided. Delivering those to those people and seeing them used was very, very heartwarming.
Odette LaRoche Art supported budding artists by quickly shifting classes to an online format and infused our community with some joy with the visually stunning Poppy Project, which not only raised money for veterans, but helped us all find a beautiful way to pause and honor our veterans during this challenging time.
I took a Georgia O'Keeffe poppy and dissected it into 30 sections, and each section is a painting in itself. And when you compose it together, the paintings stand on their own, but when composed, they form the Georgia O'Keeffe poppy. And it's pretty dramatic.
The Mary Winspear Center also found innovative ways to bring special events like Canada Day and Remembrance Day to our community. As we enter this special time of year, we want to pause and thank everyone who went above and beyond to spread joy, hope, love, and kindness. We also want to give a big shout out to the town of Sydney, the BIA, and all the members who have created a magical and enchanting place to experience the holiday season.